So with 15:36 to play in the first half, Carolina, as expected, out to the early lead. Boston College only down by 4. Side, and this was a good kick out. Henson not forcing anything. Caudle coming around. You see the pass up top and the beautiful swing of the basketball. That'll get you a...
Strickland and 1. Carolina with its largest lead of the game. And Strickland's going to the line.
They've got Strickland and Marshall out on the floor, but Strickland is the guy who is so fast with the basketball. The beautiful crossover dribble, no bigs back, no real shot blocker for BC, and he attacks the rim. Dexter's.
And Carolina at the other end. Harrison Barnes again. It's a 10-0.
Almost 2 violations back-to-back, and there's that pass, and you see everybody for BC has their back turned, not knowing where the ball is. There's the look inside. We talked about him being more aggressive. That's awfully tough to stop. I mean, Clifford.
Stop, pop, bang.
Well, here's the look, and their teams are going to play off of him, give him some room. For the Tar Heels, 12 points, but he has been very, very efficient in this game. 5 of 7 from the field. Nice attacking the rim. He's made both of his 3-point attempts. So really showing his starting Ryan Anderson. And let's see how long BC, they started the game. Jordan.
There's the leading shot. 15:54 to play. Henson with his play.
They have really tried to take advantage of that points in the paint. 33 so far in this game. You get Zeller hitting the jump hook, catching it with 2 feet inside. He's been very active posting up. Lobs over the top. Henson just too long for this front line of Boston College. Nice little fadeaway jump shot there, but they have just been very dominant.
And the followed by McAdoo.
Right there, yeah, he's just grabbing right away. Just came up a little awkward. No. 5 points, a terrific ratio, and it just seemed like it came so easy to him today, but it really didn't. Showing everything with the ability to put it on the floor. He knocked down 3s, his mid-range game. Boston College really had no answer for him anywhere on the floor. He's a tough, tough matchup.
He led.
There's the look again. See, no, he's just running free right now. Nobody is stepping up to stop the advance of the dribble. And this is great help inside. The great dig by Kendall Marshall on the drive. And I tell you, a lot more teams are playing him to make him finish, and he has blocked.
Harrison, nicely pass, and 1. Beautiful lay-in by Justin Watts. Great hang time and body control.
There's that nice pass inside. Watts operating as a backup power forward last year and working inside, shows the nice strength and finish.
Foul charge card. And a nice steal by Strickland.
Look, I mean, it's a lazy pass back onto half court, and that's just inviting the guy shooting the gap. Strickland did a nice job.
Underway with ACC action from North Carolina. Tar Heels by 3. Marshall on the lob to Henson for the two-hand slam. First butt.
There's the look, the screen right there, the slip. Kaji gets caught up in traffic trying to recover to Henson. Strength in this game for North Carolina. Kendall Marshall leading the way. Great assist right there on the screen roll with Henson, and he has been much more aggressive looking for his basket. He is perfect in this game. 3 of 3 from the floor. He's too good getting to his left hand. Miami has got it.
Cutting down the lane. Great find by Zeller.
Yeah, good find. Just
puts it ahead to Strickland.
Great look ahead and the finish for Strickland. These two have been terrific tonight. They fueled this win. The front line coming alive, but Harrison Barnes has had a tough night shooting the basketball so far, Bob. Performance by North Carolina. The front line hasn't had a great shooting night, but Henson gets the job done there. Good look inside for the layup. They've really been pounding away inside against Miami. And a couple late surges by
shooting 3 assists, 2 steals, and nary a turnover.
No, and, you know, just very aggressive right from the start, shooting the gap in the passing lanes. getting out in the open floor. We talked about how they're different. Marshall likes to, you know, a little bit slower, not quite as great an athlete.
Okoro White thought he had an easy two. Tyler Zeller with other ideas.
Here shows his quickness. There's the little dump down inside. Catch. He's so quick around the basket. Sister goes to Duke. Isn't that unbelievable? Sister Amber. She's out with a knee injury, right?
Strickland, the nice feed to Henson for the easy slam. The lead is down to six.
Good penetration, getting the ball to the interior. Once they get in that deep. Azella, great timing on the block shot. Three brothers, ready for this? Valedictorians, 3.9s, 4.0.
How will the Tar Heels respond again on the road? Virginia Tech.
Marshall by himself, spins in the lane and uses the glass. Foul is on the floor. Oh, Barnes would follow. Brown goes in and Zeller says, no way.
Our shooter able to get it over him. And boy, Robert Brown was taking that ball into Duncan. And what a great block right out of his hands. That's big time.
Just go near the bat, and there's no pressure on the ball at all.
Oh, you have to
wave it off. Screen was Henson. Nobody steps in front after he sets that screen. And that's just way too easy and not a good.
Barnes again, taking right to the hoop.
In the second half than they had in the first.
How quickly. Bullock then comes back and lets his three go and knocks it in. Henson now. Oh, now Henson from outside. And then look back at his own bench with a big smile on his face.
Yeah, what would Bill Raftery have said about this? They're just turning the corner and
send it in. Use the glass.
Chef of the puppies, the kids. Send it in.
Brought to you by Disney Parks.
Well, John Henson has blocked and changed so many shots in this game. He's been credited with six blocks, but especially in the second half, he's been everywhere. 14 points, 14 rebounds.
Center is coming up next. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Thanks for watching and enjoy SportsCenter.
Oh, that was a phenomenal play.
Harrison Barnes with the breakaway.
That was inside. Hey, take a look right here. You want to talk about some athleticism? Take a look right here, baby. They're running. Run, baby, run. They can get up and down the court.
He is the poorest free throw shooter of their starters.
He certainly won along with the kid from Kentucky. Oh, they're fired up, man. They're fired up.
That was an evil follow by Henson.
I mean, look at him get up on the offensive boards. I mean, they're attacking the glass. That means you're playing,
isn't it?
He really is frustrated. Look at that pass diagonal. There's the left-hand jam. A great look by Marshall. Watch his pass now. He knows where he is on the floor. Great pass. A little magic style with that bounce pass. The magic he used to utilize at Michigan
Seals. Now Henson tries to dish the ball.
That's a big-time play. From Henson right to his buddy Harrison Barnes. And it's Jam City, baby.
No, I know.
Hey, look at this here. A little pregame. Mr. Strickland said, I can't play, but I can dance. Mr. McDonald as well. They want to be a little Dancing with the Stars.
Two guys with bad knees.
Yeah, look at this, Dancing with the Stars. Rasheed Wallace in the house. He's wearing a...
Marshall.
Nice fake.
Oh, what a pass. Holy cow, what a pass to Harrison. He's got 7 points.
Magic flair at the pass, and there it is right here. Good pump fake, ball fake. And there's the dump down. Always thinking about finding the open man. Very
get a loss. Zeller kicks it out. White, the crowd watching. He made it.
Stillman White, who was averaging.
There is no rivalry yet. Oh, look at this little guy. He's going to tell everybody when he gets older about making the big three. And the fans love it. He'll be big man on campus tomorrow, man. Forget about Zeller. He's a big-time player. But that
Barnes.
Is a super player. That is not a big-time player. That is
5:39 left to go. There's a timeout. It's a 23-point ball game. It's the high-risers, Harrison Barnes.
A little Disney moment right down the gut of the defense. Wow, Jam City, there it is. Moment of the
ACL in his right knee. Now check this out. I spoke to him at halftime and he told me he's been icing the knee and stretching it, but the doctors told him most importantly, make sure you.
ACC basketball brings us to Chapel Hill, North Carolina, where the Tar Heels. Marshall up ahead. Seven! Oh my goodness. Swatted by Henson. He leads the ACC in blocks. Well, North Carolina, Hubert, with so much size. Look at them get out here, as per usual, pushing the pace. And then the block, Henson, a net from three. But Zeller feeds a wide open Marshall, who knocks it down. And then as well, Reggie, 33 minutes against NC State.
Well, Reggie Bullock does an excellent job of running the floor. When you have a point guard like Kendall Marshall, who always has his head up, if you are open, he is going to get you the basketball. And poor transition defense on Georgia Tech.
White buries a three. Stillman White. Stillman White. Heels lead it by nine. And the little fella burying the jumper. Carolina trying to make it 31 in a row at home. The void left by Strickland, who's such a good defender, and as you touched on, gives them that depth of point guard.
Well, their potential.
Wow, what a look. Seven assists for just past that many.
Well, you just saw he does an excellent job of throwing the ball ahead, and all of his players run the floor. They don't run, they sprint the floor, because they know if they're wide open, Kendall Marshall is going to get them the basketball. John Henson underneath the basket. Yeah, he does a terrific job using his pivot foot, being able to maneuver and get the ball to the rim. And we've already seen him knock down that 10, 12 foot.
Barnes, oh, he spins it home.
Ben Rice Jr., he's the leading scorer. Good pass. Okay, I'm going to get into the game. It's not just Kendall Marshall, it's also John Henson showing off his passing ability. And I really like the chemistry between Henson and Tyler Zeller.
Yep, Bullock, look out.
In transition.
Man. The turnover and the big fella, Tyler Zeller, one-handed jam. Left-handed or right-handed?
Well, offensively, it's just been too easy for North Carolina. Georgia Tech is a pretty good defensive team, allowing North Carolina shoots.
Back here in Chapel Hill, ACC Sunday Night Basketball. That's the North Carolina hustle board. They have had that. It's been a staple for a long time as players in the end get graded out game on certain categories, and that's all the categories that you'll see: charges, assists to turnover, screens, blocks, and the college basketball, Dean Smith. And you talk about tradition with this program. Oh! Barnes explosive to the rim. Wow. And that got some people up off the bench. And on Carolina's side, some fans out of their seats.
Harrison Barnes has been fantastic on both ends of the floor. You see him offensively, and this is something that I think he can do on a consistent basis. 6'7", quickness, athleticism. He can get to the rim anytime he wants to. 1-2 dribble right to.
Look at this alley-oop play. There's going to be a screen set right here, and that's what allows John Henson to get all the way to the basket. Little flash in the middle to occupy that middle man in the zone. Green gets the ball inside and tried to make a little move that last year would have worked great for him, but this year John Henson with those long arms able to knock it away. And because Tyler Zeller runs, and he doesn't just pass to a teammate, he passes to where that teammate's going to be. I mean, if Tom, you
know, it's an underrated skill in basketball. That's all that was for Wake Forest. You know, simple pass and catch. And Mackay, instead of making a pass fake and letting his teammate Fisher come back to the ball, or letting Kendall Marshall shoot that gap, and maybe
11-7 at Maryland.
He wouldn't have grabbed. But this is the guys I mentioned that can lead Carolina out of the wilderness
with big guys. Marshall, nice dig.
Seem to be wilting yet.
Marshall on the run, always looking for a teammate, and found Henson for the jam. It's a one-point game.
Take a look at Kendall Marshall.
Calling the big guy.
That's what makes him terrific right there.
Maryland getting a little sloppy, and Harrison Barnes with his second straight three gives North Carolina the lead.
Well, they got just worn down. Here they've got to play judiciously, because Harrison Barnes is finding the range right now.
High and an easy bucket. Barnes, that's a tough jump shot, and he made it. Harrison Barnes with a big basket. Three for North Carolina, starting to pile up the points, Len.
Well, again, and you got the horses, a number of...
That is such a remarkable statistic. Henson with a big jam. And that greets... That shot is greeted by a lot of boos in this Maryland crowd. 83-74. Henson sending a message with this one as the clock ran out.
Watch Zeller right there at the free throw line, shooting that jumper like Brad. Now Roy doesn't get a little excited. Did you ever have to listen to Mr. Krzyzewski get a little bit firm with you?
A few times. Both these coaches can get firm, yeah. But and that's just too easy for Duke shooters.
Tell you one thing, now you get the driving lead. Too many to stop them from going to the goal.
Barnes going inside with a vengeance here in the second half.
Can't teach that. You talked about it earlier. He would be so much more efficient and effective if you post up a little bit more. Here he is right there. You can't teach that. That's unbelievable.
Well, they're just dominating the paint. I mean, North Carolina's points in the paint. A great jump hook, such a nice touch inside. And you know, he can take a bump and still complete the play.
You know, you got to run that door cut right there.
Really nice finish there by Reggie Bullock. He kept his eyes up. And you're on
a year last year to the ACC tournament.
Oh, what a pass. What a pass. Perfect exit.
Unable to contain the drive. They have to help up. And James Michael McAdoo winds up getting a bucket.
Okay, one thing, he'll wind up with the bucket, but it was created off the passing ability also.
Had to go to the hook shot. Got that one rejected, but this was his.
Feed Zeller. Oh, nice touch pass. Yes, and a foul. Scott will pick up the personal.
Now, Virginia really extended their show on that. Scott going way out. But Bullock doing a nice job looking over the top, and great interior passing between Zeller and Henson.
Barnes decides to drive baseline right by Harris. No help coming. Opening half. Harrison Barnes on a baseline blast to cut it to North Carolina. A steal by McAdoo. Well, that ended that drive.
Five of those were offensive, and he had a monster game. And then James Michael McAdoo really giving them a nice pop off the bench. 8 points, four rebounds for him. The bench area has been a concern for North Carolina, but you just wonder about the war of attrition. See the double, and that's what you're supposed to do. And Zielinski, there's nothing he can do with Henson, and then we know how dominant he is.
Henson, beautiful pass by White.
Well, I think Stillman White
is against White. That was a heck of a pass, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, he really...
A whistle. There's a pass. Henson to Zeller.
The weak side is just late getting there. Now, they're double-teaming. They can't stop both of them. They're able to get to one of them, but they've played that game very well out of the double-team and the cutter on the weak side. There's the look. The double-team coming late. The guard is Harris, just too slow getting over. You've got to get in front of that. And that is just nice work by the big man inside. And Zeller
guys believe it.
Nice feed inside. Henson finishing off the dime. Carolina with numbers. Barnes on the move. And one.
the foul against Ryan Brown, and the bucket will count. And in a blink, the lead is down to three with a chance to whittle it to two.
Well, if you're going to make this foul, you got to make sure he can't get it up above his shoulders. If not, utilize something. Again, he's playing behind him now, staying on his feet, and then waiting.
Here's Barnes, a little hesitation move. Tough shot, got it. Harrison Barnes for the summer, and boy, he is a refined player this year.
Well, and he's had to be in this particular game, as his teammates haven't shot the ball particularly well. John Henson may be the only one close to shooting at a respectable percentage, but Harrison Barnes has taken it upon himself, and he's demonstrated he's had to play himself into shape.
Little drive and kick, Bullock, got it! That's a big dagger shot for North Carolina, who goes up by nine.
It's a rebound by John Henson, the failure to block him out. And then the skip pass off the penetration. And watch Bullock get set. Kendall Marshall, once again, the trigger man. And Bullock steps right into that jump shot. Well-executed play. And this man knows it. After all, he drew it up.
He sure did.
But you can say what you want. You look at the line.
We are only 13 days away from March. What's on everybody's mind? Well, dancing, of course. Clemson and seventh-ranked North Carolina. And Zeller up front, the best rebounding team in the nation, and they are still dancing in Chapel Hill. The series started in 1926. Clemson has yet
come off the bench.
Henson, follow. Desmond Hubert comes off the bench, gets a rare couple of points. The freshman from Cream Ridge, New Jersey.
Take a look right here. Hubert just left alone on the weak side, and he just goes on that bench.
Marshall, how about that? And then makes a pass that almost results. The 6:08 mark. Harrison Barnes has already scored 10 points in this ball game, to the delight of two people from his high school. Jane Jorgensen on the left, Julie Bryant on the
Clemson has thus far as Clemson goes to the 2-3, and Carolina just throws over it.
Marshall with a great pass. It's 27-14 here, and here's Kendall Marshall at work.
Yeah, delivering the perfect pass as he's aware of where everybody is and what they're doing. Many times. Emotion, a little bit of motion. How do you like that? Emotion, emotion, a little bit of motion. How do you like that? How do you like that? Welcome back to the Well, we talk about Carolina and their front line. Their front line is outstanding, particularly when it comes to points in the paint. Lead the nation
in point for North Carolina. Cobbs, Jersey on the drive here. And Barnes with a shot clock running down. Buries the three. 24 for Harrison Barnes. And a travel on Hall. Jim followed by Desmond Hubert.
Here's the look. Watch Brown. Brown's going to dig inside for the double team. And I think John Henson is a very underrated passer out of the low block.
Well, you talked about his. It's going to be on C.J. Williams.
Yeah, the slip of the screen and upside defensive. Here's the look. I mean, Kendall Marshall is as good as it gets. And right there, just people aren't getting turned around and picking up.
Mitchell had things rolling early for the Tar Heels.
Yeah, they were double teaming off of him, challenging to make plays and make shots that time. Nice job. He just really, whether in the open floor or in the half court, has total control of this offense.
First of all, it was North Carolina from three-point range.
Yeah, Harrison Barnes got off to a quick start. 9 points for him. Really good. Kendall Marshall joining it as well. How about that? These 13 points, 7 assists for him.
In the second half, he's picked up two. and now has 265 for his career.
Both of them against C.J. Leslie, doing it off the dribble, giving room a little bit, but boy, he is
Henson.
Well, we talked about it. I mean, he plays like a left-handed player. That's where he's the most comfortable.
Zeller in the post. Marshall out for three. Again, 20 points, a career high.
This.
You know, that's his first three.
He has to have a big game. But Harrison Barnes is another guy who has the other two guys in Zeller as well as
plays 15 minutes in this game because of foul trouble as Henson with a monster slam. Zeller. Jim with 3 seconds to go on the shot clock and a timeout for Virginia.
Boy, how about
points for Zeller?
And how's it in quicksand? Right here, look at Mitchell go for the pump fake. And then there's nothing to do but admire.
You want to be a.
It's senior night here in Chapel Hill as 6th-ranked North Carolina plays host to Maryland in their final home game of the season. Tyler Zeller headlines the Tar Heel senior class that look to keep pace atop the ACC.
Starters in the game, that's Marshall, who's one of the best assist men in the country. And Zeller goes right to the glass and scores again.
Yeah, all made possible by the penetration from Reggie Bullock. Getting into the middle, drawing two defenders, Alex Len having to help uphill. And anytime you help uphill, you're going to run another player. But nice pass fake, gets the ball inside. And that's just a really pretty move by John Henson. Score so much. Great play.
Reggie Bullock
does a really nice job of cutting one way and back the other and takes advantage of Maryland. You know that Kendall Marshall, if you're open, is going to find you. You got to get pressure on him to take away his vision.
Involved in the game that way. Henson throws it down.
Here comes the screen up top. They go under it. Nobody picks up. There's no rotation over. Alex Len should have been right in the middle of the lane. Instead, he was on the other side. Nice pass ahead. John Henson. He doesn't have to jump that high with those long. Move to his right and then spun around and was just able to get Terrell Stoglin to move just a bit to open up that drive. And again, you help uphill when you do. See inside, showing some poise when he gets the ball, pausing, see if double team's coming, then he can go one-on-one in the post and making the catch and finish. And he's also been blocking shots, immediately running down to the other end. And I think a lot of
in the middle of Henson gets pushed. Looked like Auslander was just trying to do whatever he could to get away from the bucket. Still goes in.
Looks like he's a little bit hurt there. Well, that was a really unselfish play by Reggie Bullock. He had a wide open shot. He passed it up to get a layup for a teammate. Instead of taking that open shot, he's got pushed from behind there. And again, finishing with that left hand.
Yeah, watching the hand come down, too. It was a push plus the whack. Zeller's going to go to the bench. And that may be it for his night as he gets a standing ovation.
Not only an outstanding player, two-time academic All-American, but a terrific young man. Really have as reliable. Nice little back kick by Reggie Bullock. A called play. A little back pick, wing back pick by Reggie Bullock on John Henson. Anytime Henson is on the perimeter and you're guarding him, you have to expect that you're tremendous hard workers. And you know, plus the senior managers got introduced too. And nobody.
Oh!
Crowd from Roberson High School in Asheville, North Carolina, the same high school that produced Roy Williams, I believe. A good looking rotation on that ball. No wonder he's got a job next year. He might not need it.
Hey, I start my mornings on Saturday. He blocks, buries a three.
So it's quite a senior night, not just for Tyler Zeller and his parents and his 30 points, but the walk-ons as well.
A terrific way to end the game. Not North Carolina's best performance, but David DuPont coming down, pulling the trigger in rhythm, and a buzzer beater to end it. That's terrific. That's great.
Once again, the final score, North Carolina 88, Maryland 64. Coming up next year on ESPN, the NBA. Chicago facing San Antonio. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Jay Billis and the rest of our ESPN crew, I'm John Saunders. Good night from Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
Champion and gets the number one seed in the ACC tournament next week. The anthem is coming up. Let's send it over to the PA announcer tonight, Trip Durham.
Can't shoot the three. Gonna watch your penetration right here. Well, I guess he had to give it up.
Well, anytime you can draw that big defender over.
Barnes, the jumper over Rivers. What a shot.
Tell you one thing,
you think of him more as a distributor. How about this shot? Acrobatic and athletic move by Marshall, and the Harrison to Barnes doing what he does best. Carolina by 13. Side Barnes, tough fadeaway. By James Michael McAdoo.
Oh, McAdoo. He's going to be special. He's going to be special. Third cousin for Robert McAdoo.
Check out McAdoo climbing that ladder again.
There he is right there. Nobody blocks him out. I mean, that's a great bounce off the floor. He's the elevator man. Watch him right here. He's going to come in for the offensive rebound. And there's the jam. Great hands.
Well, what opened that up is to get nervous. That's a block.
And it is called that way by Roger Ayers.
Tell you one thing, both clubs really struggling defensively. I mean, down on the other end, North Carolina played no defense at all, and they got an open layup. And then right here, I mean, there he is coming rolling. That's a block. There's no doubt it's a block.
A chance for a three-point play. John Henson, again, his offensive
guard as they put it past games.
Another putback. This time it's Hairston with a follow jam.
They're having a field day on the glass.
See, as the shot goes up, P.J. Hairston on the opposite side. That's just a waltz in from the right wing, and nobody puts a body on him. He puts his body on everybody else as he's dunking it over him.
Well, that's a lost start. Nobody.
15 assists to tie the ACC single season record. He got six of them in the first half. Harrison Barnes with 11. Tar Heels up big.
Cool. Now here we are, both identical records. I couldn't picture.
Numbers and then an off balance left-handed hook shot.
Wow, look at that. Looked like Billis back in his days.
One thing that North Carolina has done a really good job of in this game, they've